What makes it very powerful, you can acquire thousands of cells in a very short time frame. Basically, the data that is provided by flow cytometry gives you an unbiased, comprehensive picture about the cell population within your sample. Hi there, I'm Kitty Dora Chai, and I am the head of the fluorescent cell sorting facility here at the Max Perutz Labs.
I'm Thomas Sauer. I work here at the FACS facility as a facility manager.
My name is Andrew Kish. My main role in the facility is working as a flow cytometry operator.
Three of us, basically, we are responsible of doing all kind of part of the sorting experiments and analytical part of the experiments and maintenance of the instrument. Let's start with the backbone of our operation, flow cytometry. You have to imagine that you try to isolate a very rare cell type from a complex tissue. For instance, a very rare cancer cell type from a blood sample, similar when you're looking for a needle in a haystack. And with the flow cytometry, you can just do that. So flow cytometry is a technology that employs fluorescence labeling of marker genes or cell-specific antigens or DNA content for the identification of cells with a specific phenotype. This technique also facilitates the sorting and isolation of the cells, supporting different downstream applications such as cell line generation or sample collection for downstream analysis for genetic analyses. We have two high throughput cell sorters, including a spectral cell sorter that is capable of visualizing 40 parameters on a single cell.
The newest step of technology, it's a so-called spectral flow. With several lasers, the sample is excitated among the whole spectrum, so from about 400 to 800 nanometers. The emitted light is detected by 64 detectors. The new point is that you can measure several, let's say, colors. This is like a fingerprint. So it's definitely for every dye, it's specific. So one advantage is then that these measurements are more sensitive.
Besides that, of course, we executing experiments, analytical and sorting experiments. We also support our users on throughout every step of the experimental process, and we also dedicated to cultivating collaborative projects and relationships. We also have a user-friendly cell sorter, three cell analyzers, and a large particle sorter.
The instrument behind me is one of the advanced analyzer machines. It is one of the instruments which is heavily used by independent users. I have to mention that basically this is a kind of general a goal at the facility that for the analyzer machines we also try to encourage the new users to learn and learn how to use the instrument. Part of the role is training new users, also providing technical instructions and guidance for the users.
The fundamental mechanisms of these instruments are alike, but their practical uses diverge greatly. What is the fundamental mechanism of these instruments, right? When the cell suspension is loaded into a cytometer, the cells are transported into a so-called flow cell. This is where the sample interrogation happens when the cells pass through the laser beam. And at that point, the scattered light and the emitted fluorescence light are collected by detectors that provides you information on cell size, cell granularity, and also on the fluorescence parameters of the cells. In a large particle sorter, the sorting doesn't happen based on droplet charging because the objects here are big. We are talking about worms and 3D cell clusters and even zebrafish larvae. These are sorted based on an air pressure system.
And depending really on the scientific questions, we try to cover all of this.
It's a really kind of exciting field of the scientific work.